à Rabat, la radio qui fait la différence est sur 87.9.
Had a conversation with taxi drivers. I had a conversation with girls, women, to find out exactly what's the reason. On that basis, I sat down with them and we had some real talk about what's the reason behind why men harass women on our streets. I sat down with the taxi drivers. You know, you get a real feedback about what's going on the streets from taxi drivers. You talk about anything that concerns passengers, people complain to them about what's happening, you know, so they are at the heart of, you know, what's going on our streets in Morocco, yeah.
Yeah, well, according to what you heard from them, I mean, don't you think that some of the reasons are behind such behavior in Moroccan streets? Most people talk about the way women dress, which is...
Yeah.
At the heart of the problem,
you would be surprised. I mean, what you've said is exactly what one of the taxi drivers told me. He said to me, look, women are dressed, and Islamically dressed, in a way that lure men to come and chase them. So my question was to them, you know, this is a free country. The law allows them to dress the way they wishes to dress. But he said to me, no, that is exactly the opposite. We are an Islamic country. We have to be dressed up modestly. So there was an old man amongst the circle of the taxi drivers. And he said to me, do you know what? In my old days, women used to be treated so well in terms of men cannot even go near them because they were dressed modestly. They were respecting themselves. He said, if I'm inviting you, and if I'm showing you something, then you would come. And this is what happened with our women, he said, in Morocco at the moment.
Well, other people say one of the reasons behind this is the lack of religious commitment on the part of people nowadays. I mean, you know that Islam asks us to avoid looking at women dressed in the ways we're talking about. Don't you think as well that this lack of religious commitment is as well behind the phenomenon?
Well, I mean, one of them says, we are an Islamic country and we should be restricted, or should be at least dressed, have a dress code. So women have a dress code and men have a dress code as well. But again, you can't do that. Morocco is very diverse. Morocco has got a lot of foreigners there, has got different people believe in different ways. We obviously, if we have a religious understanding of how to behave, then probably we wouldn't have that problem. But again, you know, it's a country which very diverse, and you cannot say everyone have to be dressed in any way. So the whole issue. But let me just tell you one thing about when I went and I spoke to a few girls, and one of them, actually, first thing she said, we the girls to blame for what's happening. Another one of, you know, one of the girls in the group, she goes, you know what, you don't know what you're talking about. I dress Islamically, I put the hijab on, but I still receive this kind of treatment by men chasing me and harassing me on the street. So the whole idea about dressed up Islamically, if we are not educated enough to think that is really wrong, then whether you wear hijab or not hijab, that would make no difference. Because I've seen it with my own eyes. I mean, girls wearing their hijab and they're still being chased. I mean, one of them, this story is just made everyone in the room probably have some tears coming down their eyes. Is when one of them, she said, look at me, I'm not pretty, I'm slim, I've got hijab on, I'm dressed Islamically, and this man one day come right to my ear behind me, and he goes, he says something which I didn't understand what he was saying. So I said to him, please leave me alone, you idiot. And guess what happened next? He actually hit her. He did hit her, and he was screaming at her that she nicked his money. So he made her look bad in front of other people so he doesn't get in trouble. So he walked away. And this girl, believe it or not, she was silent for the rest of the conversation because she couldn't speak anymore. This is astonishing. Something has to be done, whether it's from the government, whether from the authorities, whether from us. And that's why I came back to London and I've written my blog and is published now for everyone to read and for everyone to share what kind of feeling our women feel in the street in Morocco.
Do you suggest some solutions for the issue?
Well, you know what? The solution, one of the girls that I'm going to read you from my blog, what she said exactly. She said, all we want is this man to feel what happening to us is happening to their sisters and mothers. And all we want is for our parents to listen to us and love us. And in return, believe me, we will be better people and we will behave in a better way. So this is the situation and this is the absolute solution that we feel what I'm doing in the street, someone else is doing it to my sister or my mother.
Yeah, so to sum it up, it's all a question of a crisis of values and education, and also on the part of the decision makers, there is kind of lack of appropriate legislation to face the
Absolutely. Phenomenon. Legislation is one, and since you mentioned education, one of the girls called Bushra, she said, our schools should become active in civil society. You've got to go there and learn more, just a lot more than that. Our schools should be a point that of education, not only about literacy, it's about life itself.
Yeah, well, I think the social media nowadays, the most people are chatting and talking to each other. The social media role should be diminishing the intensity of the problem. People are now freer. I mean, men in general now have more choices. If they're chasing girls, I mean, I'm not encouraging people to chase girls through Facebook. More opportunities are open nowadays in comparison with long ago, but although social media is active nowadays, it doesn't seem to abate the intensity of the problem.
Well, the thing is with Facebook, as you mentioned just now, it could be a good thing or could be a bad thing. I use Facebook. I've discussed many issues, and including this. This is the third time I actually posted something about this issue. The issue is big. And I'm just hoping that some of the authorities in Morocco are listening to this and they will think, yes, we should work on this. It's either by education or either by legislation. The choice is, and as we all go back, is about our government, is about society, is about us as a human being, as, you know, a Muslim country. So we should really think, I mean, women don't get that kind of harassment here in London, for instance. There may be, but not as bad. And I'm not Muslim, so doesn't, you know, the idea about we Muslim, we should be this, we Muslim, we should be that, that doesn't work. We just have to think that is wrong. Humanly, that is wrong. And that's how we should really think and how we should behave as a human being.
Okay. Well, I'm afraid we have to leave it there. That's all what we have time for. Thank you so much, Mr. Aziz Khalidi. You're head of the Moroccan Cultural Center in London, and you have posted lately this issue of women harassment in Morocco. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, too.
Araba, la radio qui fait la différence, est sur 87.9.